Hello and welcome. This is Jordan Berry, Instructional Designer at Hack, and this video is designed to give you an overview of D2L's Discussions tool. The Discussions tool in D2L allows you to create an area where you can simulate classroom discourse with your students by posting prompts that they can respond to and discuss with one another. Here, students can ask questions, share insights, post their work for peer review, or collaborate with one another on assignments. There are a number of different ways you can set up and manage discussions, but this video will look at the fundamentals of setting up and using the tool. Let's get started. Once you're logged into D2L and are in your course shell, you'll want to click on Discussions up in the nav bar. Now we're taken to a new page where eventually all of our discussion forms and topics will be displayed. First thing we'll do is click on New, and we'll see a dropdown appear. We have the options of creating a new form and a new topic. Before we start, I think it's important to briefly explain what each of these options are and how they work. So firstly, a forum is like a building where a convention is taking place, where people have come to discuss and share ideas. Within that building, there are designated rooms where people discuss to gather specific points of interest, and these are the topics. Additionally, the individual conversations people have with one another are called threads in this tool. So, before we can have our students discussing, we need to create a forum for them to meet. Within that forum, we can create one or more topics that can be housed within it, creating a space for students to engage with the content, you the instructor, and each other. Let's look at an example I've set up. So here are two forums, one for week one and another for week two. We'll notice that week one's forum, we only have one topic for students to discuss. But in week two's forum, we have two topics, topic one and two, for students to discuss. Now, there are many ways in which we can run discussion boards to engage students with meaningful discussion and problem solving. If you take a look at the information below this video, you'll see some helpful links that'll give examples on different ways that you can run your discussion boards for your class. So now that we know the difference between topics and forums, we know that we can't have a topic without a forum, so let's create one. We'll click New and then New Forum. Now we'll see that we're on the Properties tab here, and the first thing we'll do is give this forum a name. Try to choose a name that will provide students with insight into what they'll be discussing. So for our purposes here, we'll type Week 3, Mood in Literature. Now we'll see directly below this that we have an option to create a discussion topic within that forum and give it the same title. That's great if we only want to create one topic within the forum, and we don't want to specify a different title. I'm not going to select that option for our training purposes, but just know that the option is available to you. We can add a description for the forum area here, but for our purposes, I'll leave it blank. I'm going to add the student requirements for the assignment when I create each topic later on. So at the bottom here, we have a few additional options to consider for this forum. The first option allows students to post anonymously. We'll leave that unchecked because we want to know who the student is that's submitting the post so that we can assign them grades. Next, we have the ability to moderate our students' posts before they'll be published. This is a pretty safe topic, and I trust my students, so we'll leave that unchecked. The next one requires students to create and submit their own thread before they can read anyone else's. I don't want my students being influenced by one another's posts, so I'm going to check this one. What I select here will apply to all topics within this forum, though we will have the ability to customize each topic, which we'll see later on. Next, we can allow the forum description to show up in the topics. I'll leave that unchecked since we don't have a description, and we'll move on. Now we'll click Save and Add Topic, because I want to create a topic and area for students to discuss within. Okay, so now we're taken to a new area where we can create and manage our new topic. We'll see that at the top here that our form has been created and that this topic is going to be housed within it. Now below that, we'll see that we can choose the topic type. The first option is the default, and it allows everyone in the class to access the topic and its contents. The second one is designed for group work. If you create groups within D2L, you can assign certain groups to specific topics, and this option will allow students to see only the topic and posts from their group members. For this training, we'll leave it open to all. Next, we'll give this topic a title. We'll call this one Creating a Mood. Now below, we have an area to provide a description. So perhaps you want to provide the students with some instructions, requirements, or directions on the discussion post. This is where you'll do that. Here, I'll copy and paste an example that we'll use just for this video's purpose. So for this description, I've provided them an article to read, and I want them to write a short narrative paragraph that conveys a particular mood. I'm requiring them to post the paragraph to the thread in the discussion topic, and then I want them to read each of their classmates' posts and reply to three others with critical feedback that identifies the mood and offers one suggestion for improvement. Now, this example is an example of a traditional method of utilizing discussion boards for instruction. We have the instructor provide a prompt or topic, and the students must submit their responses as a new thread and then reply to two or three other students' posts. This is a fine way to run a discussion board, but there's many, maybe even more meaningful ways that you can engage your students. So you could run a class debate, create an organic Socratic-style discussion board, or run critiques of student work. Again, there are links below this video that will provide you with some ideas for creating more interactive and engaging discussion boards for your classes. Now below this, again, we'll have the options for this particular topic that we can change and adjust. I want the users to start a thread before they can read and reply to other posts, so I'll click this option. I can adjust these settings for each topic in my form if I wanted different topics to have different settings applied. But this is good for now, so we'll take a look at the next option, ratings. By default, there are no ratings applied, but if you wanted, you could have students rate each other's posts. And you do that by clicking this drop-down, and you'll see that you have a few options to choose from here. I'm not going to use this function, but I'm just letting you know that it is a possibility, so we'll leave it as it is. Now I'm finished with the Priorities tab. I'm going to scroll up, and we'll jump into the Restrictions tab. Like all assessment tools in D2L, we have the ability to control when students will see, access, and contribute to the discussion area, and we can assign due dates. First, we'll see that we can hide the discussion topic from students by clicking Hidden from Users here. But we'll leave this deselected because we want our students to see it. Next are availability dates. So when do we want our students to be able to see and start engaging with others in the discussion topic? And when do we want the discussion topic to disappear from the student's view? So we'll click here to give our discussion topic a start date. When do we want them to be able to see and start creating a response to our prompt? So we'll click Has Start Date, and we'll choose a date here. And then, when do we want the discussion board to disappear from the student's view? This selection isn't mandatory, and you may want to leave it with no end date so students can see the discussion boards that they've already completed and any potential feedback and conversation that they've had with others. Now we can also display the dates for this in our calendar by clicking here, so why not? Okay, below this we have the ability to lock our discussion topic. As a default, the discussion topic is unlocked, so students can access, write, and respond within it. We can choose to lock it, so students will not have this access, or we can unlock it for a specific date range. This is essentially a way to create a due date for our discussion post. We would want to click this third option here and create a start date for when the topic will be unlocked for students by clicking here, thereby allowing them to create their posts and responses. We will then choose a date, and then we'll want to click Has End Date for when we want this access to stop or be locked down, so students can't access this discussion post anymore, essentially creating a due date for the discussion board. And we'll choose a date. And then we'll add these dates to the calendar. So we're finished with this area, and we're going to scroll up and click the Assessments tab. Now, like all assessment tools in D2L, we can link the discussion topic to the gradebook by using a grade item. We're not going to go into great detail about grade items or how to grade discussion posts, but we will post links at the end of this video with that information included. So we want to link the discussion topic to the gradebook, and we'll do that by clicking here to create a new grade item. So a pop-up will appear and we'll give it a name, the same name as our discussion topic to minimize confusion. So perhaps week 3, discussion topic 1, mood. We can give it a short name if we'd like. Then we can scroll down and assign it a point value. We'll say it's worth 10 points. Now we'll need to remember this, as we'll need to assign the same point value to the topic itself in just a second. So we don't want them to be able to exceed the 10 points. This isn't a bonus assignment, and we don't want to exclude this from the final calculation. So we'll just click Save. Now, it appears in this grade item drop-down area here and shows that the discussion topic is connected to the gradebook. So here, we'll give this topic the same score that we did in the grade item, 10 points. Great. If we wanted to, we could create a rubric for our discussion post and attach it here. This would be great for providing students with clear information about how to earn points in the assignment and would make grading a lot quicker for instructors. So now we'll hit Save and Close, and that's it. Now we can see our new form and discussion topic appear here. And we'll see it has this icon, which means it's connected to the gradebook with a grade item. We'll also note that we have these other forms and topics here. And I'll show you how to hide these from student view quickly by clicking the drop-down arrow next to the form's name. So you'll see a drop-down will appear and we'll click Hide from Users. So we'll do that and we'll hide Week 2's form as well. Now let's take a quick look at what the students see. So now we're logged in as a student and we'll click on the Discussions tab. We'll see that our first two forms were hidden because we selected that option in the drop-down beside the title. And we can only see and access Week 3's form and topic. Great. So we'll click on the topic and we'll see that the directions that we posted are here. And we can create a new thread by clicking on this button here. The students can then add their personal responses and hit Submit. Now others, including yourself as the instructor, will be able to reply to the thread and will be able to see that whole exchange between students in our class. And that's it. That's the overview of D2L's discussion board tool. Please don't hesitate to reach out to the CDI team if you have any questions or need help along the way. All the best.